Welcome back. This is lesson 2 of my series on articles. If you haven't seen the first lesson, you will find the link to the full playlist below. All right, in this lesson, I will show you 13 uses of the definite article the. As always, there's a quiz at the end to test your understanding. Use number 1 is something we discussed in the previous lesson. This is also the most important use. Use the to talk about a person or thing known to your listener. For example, Julie has a 9-year-old son. The boy wants to be an astronaut. Here, I first say a 9-year-old son because you don't know him yet. But once I have introduced him in the sentence, I then say the boy because he's now known to you. Here's another example. Can you answer the phone? If I say this to you, then there's probably a phone ringing somewhere. So the phone is already known to you, and I say the phone. And finally, this is the watch that my sister gave me for my birthday. This example is a little different because if I stop with this is the watch, you will be confused because you don't know the watch. But then if I give you more information about the watch, it's the watch that my sister gave me for my birthday. So that way it becomes known to you. Let's now move on to use number 2. Use the with unique things. That is, where there's only one of something. For example, we say the sun because there's only one sun. Similarly, the moon, the sky, the world, the universe, and so on. Here are a couple of sentences. Everyone knows that the sun rises in the east, and Rahul has traveled all over the world. Some other things we consider unique are the government, the police, the internet, and so on. As in these sentences, the police are investigating a murder in our neighborhood, and almost everybody uses the internet today. Okay, the next use is with some words referring to nature or the environment in a general way. These are words such as the countryside, which means rural or village areas, the town, the mountains, the weather, etc. For example, my son enjoys spending time in the countryside. It means my son likes to spend time relaxing in rural areas. Here are a couple more sentences. We're going to take a trip to the mountains, and I love the weather in Los Angeles. Use number 4 is talking about objects of common experience, like in the expressions that you see on the screen. We say that these are objects of common experience because we all experience these in our lives. Have a look at this example. I met an interesting man at the park yesterday. You may not know which park, but it doesn't matter. The park is common experience. In the same way, did you read the newspaper this morning? I don't care which newspaper you read. I just want to know if you read one today. Here's another example. Darren likes to sing in the shower. We also use the with some types of media, including the word media itself, and also forms of entertainment. For example, I don't listen to the radio a lot these days, or Pooja is at the movies with her friends. Note that at the movies means at a movie theater. But it's important to note that TV doesn't work this way. You can use the with TV if you mean a television set, like, will you help me move the TV? But if you mean television as a medium, then you say on TV, as in, I saw a documentary on TV today, not on the TV. It's just a crazy rule in English. Let's move on to use number 5 now. Use the with sometime expressions. You see these on the screen. We always use the in these expressions. For example, kids hate getting up early in the morning. A friend of mine got married the day before yesterday, and we love to go swimming in the summer. We also say the past, the present, and the future, probably because there's only one past, present, and future. Like in this sentence, we must learn our lessons from the past and work towards the future. The is also found in time expressions like the 18th century, the 1960s, or simply the 60s, and so on. For example, this house was built by my grandfather in the 60s. Now, you have to be a little careful with time expressions because there are many that should be used without articles. You see some of these on the screen. We will discuss these more in the next lesson when we talk about where to use no article. The next use is superlative forms. These are expressions like the best, the worst, the biggest, the smallest, and so on. For example, Mrs. Benson is the best teacher I've ever had. Liechtenstein is one of the smallest countries in the world. And in my opinion, family is the most important thing in life. Remember that all of these are fixed. You must use the in all superlative forms. All right, here's use number 7. Use the with words such as first, second, third, previous, next, and so on when they're used as adjectives. That means we put the when these words appear before a noun. For example, Neil Armstrong was the first person to walk on the moon. When is the next presidential election? Hurry up or you're going to miss the last bus. Is it important for friends to have the same interests? Rachel is the only one here who has a driver's license. But remember that when any of these words are not adjectives, that is, they don't come before a noun, we normally don't use the. Like in these sentences, Habib came third in the race. There's no the before third, because it's not modifying a noun. And I only have 4 cookies left. Only is an adverb here, so no the. Use number 8 is with names of musical instruments. We say the guitar, the violin, the piano, the saxophone, and so on. For example, Heidi plays the guitar. Or is the violin easy to learn? So remember to put the before names of musical instruments. In the same way, to talk about scientific inventions, we often use the. For example, the telephone was invented by Alexander Graham Bell. And some say that the internet is the most important invention of the 20th century. The next use of the is when we talk about body parts. Now, usually we just use possessive forms like my, your, his, her, etc. with these. For example, she held my hand and told me that she loved me. But when we want to talk about something bad happening to a body part, we use the. The suspect was shot in the back while running from the police. Notice I didn't say in his back, I said in the back. Similarly, I was standing by the side of the road and a tennis ball hit me in the eye. So we can say in the eye, on the nose, on the head, in the stomach, in the arm, in the leg, etc. Use number 11 is referring to place names. Now, normally we use no article when we refer to names of places. We say Canada, India, South Africa, Paris, New Delhi, San Francisco, and so on. As in these sentences, I'm going to Canada on a business trip next week. Or Vincent lives in New Delhi. But some places have the as part of the name. These can be countries like the United States or the Netherlands, or it can be regions such as the Middle East or the Baltics. In these cases, you have to put the in their names. There are many other place names that have the in them. You see a list of these on your screen. So with names of seas and oceans, rivers, mountain ranges, island groups, and deserts, we use the. This is also true for names of certain types of buildings like hotels, theaters, and museums. If you want, stop the video and have a look at these. Here are some examples. Oman is a country in the Middle East. You see that there's no the before Oman, but we say the Middle East. The Alps are the largest mountain range in Europe. We stayed at the Ritz-Carlton Hotel on our last visit to Singapore. And can you get us tickets to the concert at the Sydney Opera House this weekend? Let's move on to use number 12. This is using the with family names. Now, if you watched the previous lesson, you know that we don't use the with names of people. However, this is an exception. We use the plus a family name in the plural form to refer to the family as a single group. For example, we live next door to the Smiths. They're great neighbors. This means the family name is Smith. They might have John Smith, Mary Smith, and so on in the family. But we make the family name plural to refer to the entire family. Here's another example. The Garcias have invited us to go on a picnic with them this weekend. Here, what's the family name? It's Garcia. When we make it plural, we say the Garcias. All right, let's now turn to our final use of the. This is using the word the to generalize, meaning to refer to people or things generally. We normally do this with the plus a singular countable noun that represents a group. For example, the small business owner faces more competition today than ever before. Here, I'm not referring to a specific business owner, but small business owners generally. In fact, I could say, small business owners face more competition today than ever before. It has the same meaning. Here's another example. The blue whale is the largest animal on the planet. I could also say, blue whales are the largest animals on the planet. It's also very common to use the plus an adjective to refer to a group. We do this commonly in these expressions, the rich, the poor, the unemployed, the elderly, etc. The meaning is rich people, poor people, unemployed people, elderly people, and so on. Here's an example sentence. Many people say that the government must create more job opportunities for the unemployed, meaning for unemployed people. We also use the same form to refer to certain nationalities that you see on the screen. For example, the Japanese are very polite people. Notice here that when I say the Japanese, I'm referring to the Japanese people and not the Japanese language. It's the same thing with all the other nationalities here. All right, if you're ready, it's now time for a quiz to see if you can use the definite article the correctly. On the screen, there are 8 sentences. In each sentence, I want you to put the wherever necessary. Okay, stop the video, try the exercise, then play the video again and check. Okay, here are the answers. You can stop the video and check them with your answers if you like. In the comments section, let me know how many you got correct. If you're not sure about any of these, feel free to ask me in the comments and I will help you out. All right, if you liked this lesson, give it a thumbs up by hitting the like button. Also, remember to subscribe to this channel by clicking the subscribe button to get my latest lessons right here on YouTube. Happy learning, and I will see you in the next lesson soon.